another edition of Living Akamai. In today's segment, the topic is all about lawsuit settlement and what buyers and sellers need to know. Here's Kay Mukaigawa.
There's a lot of talk about the National Association of Realtors lawsuits. So today, we have one of our own, Christina Nishiyama, Senior Vice President of Engel and Volkers Honolulu here. You know, Christina is very involved with the national board, as well as being an educator. She was our past MLS president. She's very involved in our local board, and in fact, recently sat on a panel discussing this very issue for the professionals in our industry. Christina, what's going on with this lawsuit that we're hearing about?
Some of the rules that were focused on was that sellers were forced, was the allegation that they were forced to pay compensation to all buyer's agents, regardless of their experience, their knowledge, or even the services that they provided. So they felt that that was unfair, and that's really where this lawsuit was centered around.
Gosh, I've been a realtor for 37 years in this industry, and I know for a fact that compensation has always been negotiable. So how does this affect the buyer and seller community?
Yeah, absolutely. Negotiations have always been around. Compensation was never a requirement to pay a certain amount. And really, that's where the confusion, I think, lies, is the headlines have really splashed out to make realtors really have a bad name. But what they don't realize is that when you look at the statistics, buyers and sellers need guidance. They need the professional advice from realtors to take them down that path, that journey, because it is truly, it is the biggest financial investment of their life.
So what changes are being made?
So it's going to be focused on policy and rule changes. So there's going to be two changes that they are proposing that we are going to be seeing effective mid-July. And one is that the compensation in the multiple listing service is no longer going to be advertised. So if there's any kind of concessions that the seller is offering, which could include compensation, will no longer be on the MLS. So what that means is that agents and buyers will now have to contact the sellers through their agents to determine what that might look like. The second thing, which is really important, is buyer's representation. It is going to be required now with anyone that's a member of the National Association of Realtors, professionally will need to sit down with their buyers and go over a buyer's representation contract and make sure that it is signed before they can even show any properties to a buyer.
So the big change again is, if you're my client, I have you sign a listing agreement only for my portion of the compensation. And if you are my client as a buyer, you sign an agreement with me before we go out and we talk about that compensation.
Yes, in a nutshell, that is the case. As a listing agent, you will be able to talk about both, but really you're hiring your listing agent to sell your home.
You know, buyer's representation, gosh, is such a key thing. I have been a realtor for a long time, and I admit I am predominantly someone who has done a lot of listings. But the buyer's agent is so darn important, and sometimes we forget about that. But yet, this lawsuit brings light to how important the buyer's agent is.
Absolutely. I am actually very happy, elated that this is happening, because I think it's a positive effect on our industry. It's going to elevate our professionalism. Buyer's agents are not just door openers to houses. We don't just get the key and open the door. We will earn our commission that we always should have been. We have the same fiduciary duty under our license as we would when we represent sellers. But at the same time, they will know how hard buyer's agents work for them. You know, there's so much due diligence, and I always say this, buyers and sellers don't know what they don't know.
In looking at what realtors do is really the heart of this settlement, right? Because there was a settlement going on.
Absolutely, and I do want to say that I've been doing this for many years, and you know that. So when I'm presenting my offers, I not only, of course, highlight all the wonderful things that the buyers bring in their offer and all the strategies that they put forth to bring the to package that for the seller, but I also have pitched for many years about my experience and what I bring to the table to help them close that deal. Because deals can fall apart for so many reasons, and if there's misunderstandings or they don't understand why the seller is saying something, or why, as you as a seller's agent, why is the buyer saying that? And through the process of our experience, our knowledge, and when I say education, why it's so critical. So when you see those alphabets after realtors' names, those are our degrees. Those are our education, our certifications that we have spent hours and invested money on training to make sure that we are at the cutting edge. We know all the laws that are changing, not just the basics. We are one step above that. And so when you're hiring realtors, you're going to see the difference now as you're sitting down at the table every time with every buyer, so they know what kind of service they're getting.
Thank you, Christina. If you have any questions or would like to speak to Christina, give us a call at 808-725-2000. We look forward to seeing you next week, Tuesday. Engel & Volkers Honolulu is here to help you live Akamai.
You were listening intently.
I was, yes. It's a good one. I mean, it is going to be affecting realtors in general. And buyer representation is so important. I think the buyers, so many of them too, especially first-time home buyers that don't realize what they're getting themselves into, to have that legal representation is so important. And as Christina was saying, you know, when you're putting in an offer, the agents recognize a good agent too. There's a chance that if they've worked with you in the past before, have had a good experience, that an offer, you know, if it's tied, right? If they're trying to decide who to choose, mm-hmm. if they know that, oh, this person is likely gonna help us close, they can go with them. So both buyers and sellers agents are important, should be compensated. As they said, it's always been negotiable, but now you're gonna have to get those agreements signed beforehand.
I knew you'd know.
Yeah, it's interesting.
Yeah,
I think, yeah, good things though. As long as buyers continue to get the representation that they deserve.
Yeah. Okay, good stuff. Yeah. And we've got a lot of great stuff from Kay on our website, kay212.com. Mm-hmm. Go to the Living 808 tab, and then, of course, the Living Akamai.